please do not confuse yourself that this problem to be a discrete series problem. This problem is individual series problem. So in this problem, they are asking us to find out mean deviation about mean as well as mean deviation about median. And we are also supposed to find coefficient of mean deviation. Okay, so that is the complete problem. Now let's go on and solve the problem for us to understand it better. Okay. So going to the solution, first we will be solving the problem under mean. Okay, so the heading goes like this: calculation of mean deviation and coefficient of mean deviation about mean. Okay, so we'll be considering arithmetic mean and we'll be finding out the problem solution. Now let's see what have we taken from the question. So from the question, I already told, please do not mistake it to be a discrete series, because student's roll number does not make any sense in the question. It is not relevant in the question. So what we will take from the question is only marks. This marks, that is 60, 60, 55, 75, this marks is only be considered. Okay. So here, when you take up the marks, 60, 55, 75, that is written as X here. Now, since it's an individual observation method or individual series, so we total this sigma X. So once we total all these numbers, we are going to get 600, that is your sigma X. Next column. Now, according to the series, whatever we saw, we were supposed to arrange the data in ascending order. Now, for calculation of arithmetic mean, arranging them in ascending order is not required. Then we'll have to calculate the deviations, that is modulus D. Now, how to find modulus D? We have X. We have X here, that is X, 60, 55, 75. And we have to find out X bar, that is nothing but arithmetic mean. How to find X bar? The simple formula: sigma X, add all the X, divide by number of data. Now, how many data do we have? The question clearly told us there were 10 students' marks. If you see here, there were 10 students. There were 10 students' marks which was given. So we are going to consider the 10 students' marks. So once you add up all the X, it is 600, and then you divide that by 10. So your arithmetic mean is 60. So how did we find arithmetic mean? Sigma X by N, normal formula. So we found out 60 as the arithmetic mean. Hope everybody understood until here. Okay, so let's just go on and solve mean deviation. Now, before that, let's find modulus D. How to find modulus D? X minus X bar. Now, X bar is 60, which is fixed. Okay, X bar is 60, which is already fixed. Then, so we will take all of them now. 60 minus 60 of X bar is 0. 55 minus 60. Understand? 55 minus 60 is usually minus 5. Okay, it's not plus 5. But since we have modulus, that is two lines here, two lines before D and after D, this minus sign will not be considered and it will become plus sign. Okay, so 55 minus 60 is plus 5 only because there is modulus sign. Then 75 minus 60 is 15. Then 80 minus 60 is 20. 50 minus 60 is 10. 44 minus 60 is 16. 48 minus 60 is 12. 56 minus 60 is 4. Again, see here, you will get minus, but since it's modulus, you have taken it as plus. Here also, 48 minus 60, you'll get minus 12. But since we have modulus, we take plus. 78 minus 60, 18. 54 minus 60, 6. Okay, so we found out modulus D. Now add up all the modulus D. So the value of modulus D is, summation of modulus D is 106. Okay, so summation of modulus D is 106. Now after this, after finding out sigma modulus D, let's go on and find out mean deviation. Now what is the formula for mean deviation? Sigma modulus D by N. As simple as that. Here we have sigma x by n. In place of x, I am taking this deviation which we have found out. So that is sigma modulus D by n. So which is 106. From here, if you see, this is 106 divided by n. N will remain same. 10 and 10. N will remain same. So your mean deviation is 10.6. Okay, so mean deviation is 10.6. Now after this, we have to calculate coefficient of mean deviation. Coefficient of mean deviation formula. Since we are finding it from arithmetic mean, we will take arithmetic mean here. So mean deviation divided by arithmetic mean or x bar mean. So what is mean deviation? We just found out 10.6. Okay, 10.6 is the mean deviation. This is considered here directly divided by x bar. X bar is nothing but the mean, which is 60. So this is considered below this. So 10.6 divided by 60 is equal to 0.1766. So this is the coefficient of mean deviation. Okay, so this completes half of the problem where they had asked us mean deviation and coefficient of mean deviation from mean. I'll just summarize this first half of the problem. They have given us the marks of 10 students, that is X, which is given here. These are the 10 students' marks which is given. If you add them up, they are called as sigma X. Okay, then we will go on and calculate arithmetic mean, that is X bar is equal to sigma X by N. So 600 from sigma X divided by N are 10 students' data. So 600 by 10 is 60. After this, we have to calculate the modulus D or deviations. Now, how do we find out deviations? X minus X bar. So X, we already have the data here. X bar is 60. So 60 is fixed. So you subtract X from X bar. 60 minus 60 is 0. 55 minus 60 is 5. Like this, you find the modulus D. Do not consider minus values because it is modulus. We ignore the signs. Now, once you add up all of this modulus D, the total will come up to 106. Now, this 106 is supposed to be taken to calculate mean deviation. Now, how do we calculate mean deviation with this formula? Sigma modulus D divided by N, that is 106 divided by 10. From where did we get 106? Your sigma modulus D divided by N is 10, that is 10 students. So mean deviation is 10.6. Then coefficient of mean deviation. Since we are solving from arithmetic mean, mean deviation divided by arithmetic mean or X bar. So mean deviation is 10.6 divided by X bar is 60. Okay, so your total coefficient of mean deviation is 0.1766. Okay, so that is the coefficient of mean deviation. Okay, hope everybody understood the problem until here. So if you have any doubt, you can leave it in the chat. Everybody understood the problem? Okay, good. So let's go to the next half of the problem. This was the only the first half. So because there, if you see the question, they have asked us to find mean deviations from mean as well as median. Now let's go to median. Now whenever we go to median, we have to first calculate the median, right? So calculation of mean deviation and its coefficient about median. Now, let's follow the steps, however, they have given to us. Arrange the data in ascending order. Now, for to calculate median, we have to arrange the data in ascending order. So, if you see the data here, the data started from 40, sorry, the state data started from 60, 55, 75, 80. But if you see here, the data is already arranged in ascending order from the smallest number to the largest number. So, we have arranged the data in ascending order starting from the smallest number. Then, after this, we have calculated median. Now, median for the individual series will start with the finding of the size of median. So, size of n plus 1 by 2th item. So, for quartiles, it is n plus 1 by 4. For median, that is Q2, it is n plus 1 by 2 item. Now, in the place of n, how much data do we have? We have 10 students' data. So, that is what we have considered here. Size of 10 plus 1 by 2. So, size of 11 by 2. 11 by 2 is 5.5. Okay, so 11 by 2 is 5.5th item. Now, after this, what are we supposed to do? Once we find out 5.5th item, how do we find the median? Now, if you see, 5th item plus 0.5. 5th item plus, 5th item is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5th item is 55. Okay, so 55 plus 0.5. This 0.5 will remain, right? So, 0.5 into 6th item minus 5th item. That is 56 minus 55. Once again, I will repeat. So, here to find the median value, it is 5th item plus 0.5 into 6th item minus 5th item. So 55 plus 0.5 into 56 minus 55. So 55 plus 0.5 into 1. 56 minus 55 is 1. So the median value for us is 55.5. So overall, we found the median value for individual observations. Okay, this is only for individual observations, which is 55.5. Now, we found out the median. What is the next step? Next step is for us to calculate the deviations. Okay, we are supposed to calculate the deviations. How do we calculate deviations? For arithmetic mean, we calculated the deviations. Okay, we calculated the deviations x minus x bar. That is modulus x minus x bar. Similarly, for a median, we are going to calculate the deviations again with x minus median. So, modulus x minus median. So, median we found out 55.5. That is fixed. You are supposed to subtract x from this value. Starting with first number 44. 44 minus 55.5 is 11.5. You get minus values again. Since we have modulus, we are going to ignore the signs and take it as positive number. Then 48 minus 55.5 is 7.5. 50 minus 55.5 is 5.5. 54 minus 55.5 is 1.5. 55 minus 55.5 is 0.5. 56 minus 55.5 is again 0.5. 60 minus 55.5 is 4.5. Likewise, we calculated deviations for all of the numbers. Once you calculate the deviations, add up all of this deviations, that is called as sigma modulus d. Okay, we calculated modulus d, that is deviations. So, add up everything, then it is called sigma modulus d, which is equal to 98. So, we first arrange the data in ascending order. We found out median, we found out deviations, and we totaled all the deviations. Now, let's go on and calculate the mean deviation and its coefficient from median. Now, mean deviation about median. In exams, please make sure you write this from about mean, about median, about mode. Whatever is asked in the question, write that out. Okay, so mean deviation about median. The formula is sigma d divided by n. There's a little spacing problem. So sigma d divided by n, 90, how did we get 98? That is from the sigma modulus d, which is 98. So 98 divided by 10. So this 10 was supposed to be here. Okay, 98 divided by 10. Then that is 9.8. So mean deviation is 9.8. Then next, coefficient of mean deviation. Now coefficient of mean deviation, what is happening here is we take mean deviation divided by median. Okay, so we take mean deviation divided by median. So 9.8 was our mean deviation. So we take 9.8. Okay, this is another decimal which has been added here. That's all. So 9.8 divided by median. Median is how much? 55.5. The same 55.5 is considered here also. So mean deviation is 9.85 divided by 55.5, which is equal to 0.1765. So that is the coefficient of mean deviation from median. We found out from mean, we found out from median. So that completes our problem of mean deviation calculation for individual series. Okay, so hope everybody understood the problem completely of both mean deviation from mean as well as median. Can you please leave it in the chat if you have understood or if you have any doubt? Okay, that's great. So everybody has understood the problem. Now next, computation of mean deviation for discrete series. So we are supposed to take the solve the problems under discrete series. Okay, so discrete series, how do we take the problem and solve it? Let's see that. Now mean deviation is equal to, see the formula here, the mean deviation is equal to sigma f modulus d by n. Now in discrete series you will be having, you're going to have frequencies, right? So for that scenario we are going to use this sigma f divided by modulus d. Okay, sorry, sigma f into modulus d divided by n. Then what are the steps? Arrange the data in ascending order, compute median or mean as required. So first we will arrange the data in ascending order. For median we will arrange, for mean it is not necessary. Then compute d, again same thing, x minus median or x minus x bar. Okay, so this is x minus x bar. Next, multiply individual frequency in and individual modulus d. Now frequencies will be given, x will be given, frequencies will be given. We will calculate modulus d. Afterwards we'll have to multiply frequency into modulus d. Then we have to add up that, which is f into modulus d, which will be called as sigma ft. After this we will have to apply the formula for mean deviation, sigma f modulus d divided by n. Okay, so this is a very simple, since we have understood individual series, discrete series is also very similar and simple one. Okay, let's go on and solve the first problem. Now calculate mean deviation and its coefficient from mean. Okay, please be very careful. It's directly given from mean as well as median. So if you understand, they're asking us from mean as well as median. Both they are asking. Now let's see the data. X, F. Now here X is given, F is given. So we are going to consider both of them and calculate the problem or solve the problem. Okay, so let's go on and solve the problem. Now, calculation of mean and mean deviation. First, we will take calculation of arithmetic mean and mean deviation. So what are the points? Let's see here. First, we will take X as it is, right? X is column is taken as it is. F is also taken as it is. And we have added F, which is the total of F is also known as N. That is number of data, that is 352. Then, let's see for the next. We have to calculate arithmetic mean. Now, arithmetic mean or X bar, the formula for discrete series is sigma fx divided by n. So our next column will be fx. Why are we calculating fx? We are calculating fx so that we can find out arithmetic mean. Okay, sigma fx divided by n. Now you multiply x into f where you get this data. You add up all these numbers. You get the total of 49,560. When you divide 49,560 by 352, okay, so if you see here 49,560 divided by 352, which is n, you get an arithmetic mean of 140.795. Okay, so we found out the arithmetic mean. So until now, what did we do? We wrote down x, we wrote down f from the question, we multiplied x into f to find out fx. We added F, we added FX. So 49,560 divided by 352 will give you an arithmetic mean of 140. Then, now, what are we supposed to do in the next step? After this, we have to calculate the modulus D. Once we calculated the arithmetic mean, we have to calculate modulus D. Now, how to calculate modulus D? Same formula. X minus X bar. Okay, this is X bar. That is nothing but what we just found out, 140.795. So that is the X bar. Now, so we are supposed to take X. Be careful. We are supposed to take X. So 115 minus 140.795 will be 25.795. 125 minus 140.795 is 15.795. 135 minus 140.795 is 5.795. See, since there is three decimals here, it feels like a bigger number. So be careful while subtracting. Please write the proper numbers or put the proper numbers into the calculators while calculating. Okay, likewise, when you find out the difference between X, when you find out the difference between X and 140.795, you get these numbers. Now, don't add them. Wait, do not add this modulus D. Okay, for discrete series, we have to multiply this D, this modulus D along with F. Okay, we are supposed to multiply F and modulus D. Now, let's see. We are supposed to multiply F and modulus D. Now, 31 into 25, 31 into 25.795 will give us 799.645. 48 into 15.795 will give us 758.16. 72 into 5.795 will give us 417.24. 116 into 4.205 will give us 487.78. Likewise, we multiply every number here of F with modulus D. So we multiply all of these numbers and we get these answers, that is F into modulus 3. Okay, no minus numbers. We are supposed to ignore signs because it is modulus D. Now add Am I audible now? Can you hear me now? Okay, let's continue the problem. Sorry, there was some slow connection of internet, which just disconnected for a moment. Okay, so let's just continue the problem. We were multiplying sigma fx, modulus d into frequency. So once we multiply everything, okay, once we multiply this frequency and modulus d and add all of them, we get 3950.25. okay, so once we get this, what is the next step? The next step is to calculate mean deviation. So here in mean deviation, the formula is sigma f modulus d divided by n. Now let's see what is sigma f modulus d. That is 3950.25. so if you see here, the sigma f modulus d is 3950.25. so we are supposed to consider this 3950.25 and by n is 352, which was already here, 352. The same thing we are going to consider. So our mean deviation is going to be 11.222. okay, when you divide 3950 by 352, it is going to be 11.222. so that is our mean deviation. Now mean deviation, the coefficient for that mean deviation has to be found. Since we are finding it from arithmetic mean, we will take the formula mean deviation divided by x bar. So mean deviation is 11.222 divided by x bar, which we already found out, that is 140.795. okay, so we are going to consider that x bar or the arithmetic mean. So we get a coefficient of 0.0797. so this is the coefficient of mean deviation for the particular data given to us. Okay, so this is how we find out the mean deviation and coefficient of mean deviation from mean for discrete series. But in the question, they have also asked us to find out for median. Through median also we are supposed to solve the problem. Okay, hope everybody understood this problem. Anybody has doubt in the first half of the problem? Okay, now let's go on and solve the problem in median. Okay, calculation of median and mean deviation and its coefficient. So this is a discrete form of data. So we are supposed to find out the median here. Now first will be x as usual, then will be f. Now to find out median, we are supposed to calculate cumulative frequency, right? In quartiles also, that is what we did. So we are supposed to calculate cumulative frequency. How to calculate cumulative frequency? 31. The first frequency will remain same. Then 31 plus 48, 79. 79 plus 72, 151. 151 plus 116 is 267. 267 plus 60 is 327. 327 plus 22 is 349. 349 plus 3 is 352. So we are going to add the frequencies one by one to find cumulative frequencies. And total of your frequency, that is n, is 352 as usual. Now for calculation of median, the data should be arranged in ascending order, which is already in ascending order. Okay, we need not worry too much about the ascending order part here because it's already present in ascending order. So we calculated the cumulative frequency. Now let's go on and calculate median. Now how to calculate median? Let's see the calculation. Median is equal to size of n plus 1 by tooth item. The median value we'll have to calculate using the same formula, n plus 1 by tooth item. Again, n is 352 plus 1 by 3, which is 352 plus 1 by 2, 353 by 2. So your median is 176.5th term. Okay, 176.5th term. Now, how do we find this 176.5th term? Now, check the cumulative frequency for the next highest number. So let's go and check the cumulative frequency after your 176.5th item. 151 is less than 176. 267 is more than 176. So 267, you have to check the cumulative frequency. And after that, its corresponding X. 267 is the next highest cumulative frequency. Its corresponding X, that is 145. Okay, this is the value of median. That is the value of median, which is 145. Okay, so we found out median to be 145 here. Okay, so we already understood how to find the median. Then, after this step, go back and calculate in the table the deviations or modulus d. How do we calculate modulus d? Is x, that is modulus x minus median value. Median value we already found out it to be 145. So x minus 145. How do we find 115? X minus, so 115 minus 145 is 30. 125 minus 145 is 20. 135 minus 145 is 10. 145 minus 145 is 0. Again, 155 minus 145, 10. 165, 145 is 20. 175 minus 145 is 30. So we found out the difference between X and median. But again, please remember, you have to ignore the signs because we have given the modulus. Okay, modulus is considered, so ignore the signs. Now, after finding out modulus D, our next job is to find out frequency into modulus d. Now, we already have frequencies given in the question for us. After frequencies, we are supposed to multiply the frequencies into modulus d to find f modulus d. So, this frequency into modulus d will give us f into d. So, 31 into 30 will give us 930, 48 into 20, 72 into 10, 116 into 0 is 0. Okay, please don't write 116 there. 60 into 10, 22 into 20, 3 into 50. Okay, so this is the calculation for F modulus D. Okay, F into modulus D. Then after this, we'll have to add up all of the F into modulus D. And once we add all of the f into modulus d, the value, the total value that we get, that is 3740. When you add up all of these numbers, you get 3740. So we calculated sigma f modulus d. Now let's go on and calculate mean deviation from median. So mean deviation from median also, same formula, sigma f modulus d divided by n. That is 3740. The total of 3740 is considered. Divide that by n, which is 352. So your answer is going to be 10.625. Okay, so the mean deviation.